Right, should be going live any second. I've actually got a new laptop, which is quite powerful. I've got it rigged up to my semi-professional video camera, which is acting as a webcam, which is piped through HDMI into Blackmagic Intensity Pro Shuttle. I don't know if it's Pro, it's Intensity Shuttle anyway. And then that's coming through USB 3 into my laptop and onto Wirecast. And I've done a couple of smaller tests, which seem to be all right. This is my 1080p HD test, hoping it's all going to be all right. So I'm just going to look at the live stream. I'm going to look. Yeah, that looks beautiful. So the internet is on wireless, transmitting to my internet the other side of the room. So that's brilliant. I've got my professional voice mic, Sennheiser voice mic above me, which is, it's a lovely little mic here. So it's a very low noise mic, this Sennheiser. It's the go-to voice mic that most professionals use on video. So really pleased with that. I can't remember what the number is of it. So the camera is my Sony, I think it's PWX or PXW X70, which it's got the 4K upgrade built into it. I only use 1080p at the moment, but a beautiful little camera. Really, you can set it up before you start to get your white balance right and that. And if I want to, what I can actually do with this is set it on record while I'm making these live broadcasts. So I've got a recording of it as well. I don't know how to upload that because hopefully these will be good enough for now. It's uploading at 4,600 gigabytes per second, and my Wi-Fi and everything seems to be handling it. So just looking at the image again, it looks absolutely fine. So I'm really over the moon. I took a big chance because you've got to have a certain sort of motherboard on your laptop or PC to handle this Blackmagic and the Intensity Shuttle. So you've got to have a certain sort of keyboard, motherboard to handle it. And tried contacting the sellers, only got it 2 weeks ago, less than 2 weeks ago, and contacted Lenovo, and not a clue. Absolutely useless help. So I contacted Blackmagic and gave them the processor, which is a 2.8 processor, boosts up to 3.5 maximum. And I've seen it go over that at times. I mean, I've got the performance up now. I'll read it out in a minute. I mean, I contacted Blackmagic and told them what my laptop processor was and that kind of stuff, and how much memory I got and stuff, because I've got loads of memory on here. Put 32 gig of memory on it and stuff. I got that, and I took the chance on it because it's £180. It's not cheap. Just to take the chance on it would work, and I put it in, wouldn't work. Saw a video a couple of months ago about somebody that was using a more basic model of my camera, the consumer camera rather than the pro camera. And he said, look, this is what I had to do to get it working. And it wasn't using it on the same software because I'm using Wirecast to upload it to YouTube. And in the end, I went and watched his video again, and it gave me an idea about changing some of the settings, output HDMI settings on the camera. And when I set it from P, which is progressive and PAL, to I, which is whatever it is now, but it's just one single frame at a time, I does, rather than progressive frames. So it's 25 per, on PAL it's 25 frames per second. It was great. It started working straight away. Got a picture on it, and then I put my microphone on to test that. Obviously, when I got my speakers on, it does this. So yeah, getting feedback off the microphone and the speakers, so you have to turn your volume off, but it's okay if you're in chat, isn't it? It doesn't matter, you know what I mean. So I'll probably make this one live just to see how it goes. Everybody can check it out. I know it's going a bit, losing a bit when I'm moving about, you know what I mean. It's not 100% perfect, but I'd say it's a pretty good setup, and I've got a lovely mic on here. It's coming straight down the HDMI, the picture and sound, into the Blackmagic, straight into Wirecast, and working great. So I've got fiber optic broadband on wireless. I am, but I've got fiber optic broadband, so my performance on here, and this is uploading at 4,600 gigabits per second, so my processor's 2.8, but it goes up to 3.5, and I've seen it spike over that at times, but it's doing about 3.3 to 3.4 at the moment, so it's maxing out, but my old computer couldn't handle it at all. So my Wi-Fi is uploading at 0.1 to 2 megabits per second, so that's more than handling it. It'll do 14 megabytes per second. So I've not got the Ethernet in because it doesn't make any difference. My memory, I'm using 4.5 out of 31.8. CPU, yes, 39%, 40% utilized. It's an i7 processor, really fast. So, but in the gigahertz, it's up around 3.3 to 3.4, max is 3.5. So, yeah, overall, it's really good utilization of this computer, about 41%. I've got four cores in this processor. It's the newest i7, come out in January of 2017. It's got one socket, max speed 2.81 gigahertz, it says, but it's got a boost on it. So logical processors 8, virtualization's disabled, Hyper-V support, yes, and it's got L-Cache 1, 256 gigabytes, whatever that is. L-Cache 2 is 1 megabyte and L-Cache 3 is 6 megabytes, so you know, just spaces it out, I guess. But for anybody that's interested in using Wirecast and, you know, these things, it's all information, isn't it? So yeah, my old laptop, it was 3 years old. I kept it for an extra year because I bought this camera last year instead of another laptop, and yeah, I spent a lot of money on this laptop, but it's super powerful. The other day, I uploaded my 4K life story the other day, and that took me between 8 and 11 hours to process. I can't remember what it was now, but when I rendered it, made it into the MP4 video, it actually took about 8 or 9 hours to render it, and this one did it in under 2 hours. So it's about 5 times quicker at rendering videos, because the old one had Mercury playback, but this has got Mercury playback, this processor, plus CUDA, I think it is, or something like that. So it's got a better engine to render, to watch videos in Premiere Pro. Once you put color changes and different things on your videos, you have to keep rendering it all the time to make it play properly, and that takes ages. And this one, you don't have to render it. You can put in, you know, transitions and color alterations, all the rest, it plays it perfect. And that old laptop, which was a 2.7 gigahertz processor on that one, I couldn't play 4K on it at all. Even when I'd reduced it from 4K down to 1/8 playback, it still wouldn't do it. It kept juddering and stopping and freezing and crashing. This one, I put 4K on there, and I had to use a proxy file, a smaller 720p proxy file, to edit my video and then relink it to the 4K, the 4K in the end. But this one, it plays 4K at 4K. It plays it at 4K. Amazing. And I can edit my 4K video when I start making them later on, because I'm going to shoot everything in 4K later on. Be able to edit my 4K video in this laptop. It's amazing. It is truly amazing. But because it's 4K and I've only got a HD screen on this 1920 by 1080 pixels, that I just watch it in half resolution, because, you know, you're getting a perfect image out of it then. So yeah, I struggled a bit with a bigger screen on here, because, you know, my old screen was quite a bit smaller. You just have to watch you have to resize everything to 125%, other than when you're in Premiere Pro, to be able to read text and stuff. But it's brilliant. So I am over the moon with this laptop, over the moon today with this camera and the way it's working, the sound, sweet. I mean, the sound on here, it's beautiful. This microphone, it's got a bit of hiss on it, a bit of noise on it, but it's half that of a normal Rode NGT, I think it is, too. It's half the amount of noise, so you know it's listenable to it without too much hiss in your ears if you've got earphones on and stuff like that. But normally when I make a video, and I will actually record my live sessions in future, when I make a video, I will actually be, you know, downloading it afterwards, and then I can take the audio hiss out if I want to. So we'll see how it goes. Anyway, I won't keep you too long, because I kept you long enough. Thanks for watching. I'm going to make this one live, I'm sure, because it's I want to see what it's like first. But to me, yeah, I mean, I move about a lot when I'm speaking. I'm blinking away. This is because I've got short-term memory loss. I'm sitting there blinking so much because I it's sort of a break for my mind. When I blink a lot, it gives my brain a chance to think, because I've always suffered with short-term memory loss since I was a child, and academically at school was hopeless. You know, I couldn't do English. I could hardly read and write when I come out of school still. So, but, you know, getting internet, you soon learn to read and write, don't you? And my spelling is atrocious, but I'll do my best. So anyway, thanks for watching. Good to see you. Love and light to you all. Have a good week. Neil.